has expired. The next is the gentlelady from Michigan, Ms. McClain.
Good afternoon, Mr. Secretary. First, I want to thank you for being here today. I do appreciate it. I have a limited amount of time, so I want to ask you just three really very simple questions. Yes and no answers are fine. And honestly, these are not trick questions. Would you agree that ensuring our nation has a strong labor market is really paramount for our recovery?
I completely agree with you.
Thank you so much. And then historically, economies that have millions of job openings, typically that would mean low unemployment would follow, correct?
You're right, correct. In a normal circumstance, when we're not dealing with a pandemic, yes.
My third question is, would you agree that it is best to have American citizens working and making a positive contribution to our economy rather than receiving unemployment benefits?
As a former mayor, absolutely. I wanted to get my unemployment rate as low as possible, wanted to create as many good jobs as possible in the city of Boston in my time there.
Thank you so much. I'm glad you agree with me on these basics. Now, I continue to hear from employers and businesses in my district that they're unable to find people who are actually willing to work due to this administration's enhanced unemployment benefits. You testified that you agreed with me that it is best to have Americans working rather than relying on the government. The facts are clear that the unenhanced unemployment benefits are hindering our recovery, especially here in my district. So I ask you, I am looking for a time frame, when will it be necessary to end these benefits if the recent jobs reports aren't enough of a sign?
Let me thank you. I'm just writing some notes down just so I got it all. Thank you for this line of questioning. I think it's an important conversation to have, and I think we need to continue to have this conversation.
Seems like there's a reverse, or we're missing cause and effect.
Well, I think that one thing I think we have to be, again, remain cognizant of, we are still in or coming out of a global pandemic that the likes of which we haven't seen in the United States of America in 100 years. In saying that, the benefit, the unemployment extension benefit expires in September. And when you look at President Biden's recovery plan, we've added in the last 4 months, over 2.1 million jobs have been added to our economy. And as we think about, as we see the connection between the CDC, reducing some of the restrictions on masks and restrictions, as we see states and cities around the country reduce and come back on some of their restrictions on COVID, we're seeing more and more people enter into the workforce. And as we start seeing childcare facilities open and schools open, and hopefully summer camps open, that's going to be key. We're going to see more and more people go back into the economy.
So are you optimistic that at the end of September, these enhanced benefits will be done?
Yeah, I mean, that they expire then. They do expire then. And I'm also hopeful and optimistic that our economy and more people will be working by the end of September.
We're on the same sheet of music. I mean, we have 9.3 million jobs, and we don't have people to fill those jobs. My concern is if we don't keep the businesses open by the time the enhanced unemployment benefits run out and expire in September, they won't have any businesses to go back to work to. So I think you and I are on the same sheet of music. But why do you and President Biden remain so committed to the unnecessary spending of the taxpayer dollars on these benefits? Do you really think they're needed?
I do honestly think they're needed. I really do.
The numbers and the data we have?
Well, the numbers and data is how people read them, quite honestly. And I think that there's still a lot of pain in this country. People have lost their job. People have lost the industry they worked in. Many of the restaurants that are looking for workers now, about 25% of our restaurants, roughly, at least I can speak for Boston, I can't speak for the country, are out of business, not because of not having workers, because of the pandemic.
And sir, I have I think you and I are close on this. One last question before I yield my time back. Am I hearing you correctly that you will commit to this committee to ending these unnecessary benefits as soon as possible? Hopefully in September.
No, I won't commit to ending them as soon as possible, but they expire in September. So for all intents and purposes in September, they expire. So that I guess you could say at that point they end.
Thank you for your time, sir. I yield back.
I appreciate it. Thank you.